I'm Max Sterling, welcome to LarpMix. Today I'm going to show you how to make an awesome sword hanger for your wall that's basically free to make. It's going to look really awesome, and it gives you something to do with your LARP weapon in the downtime in between games so you can display it. Because a lot of these newer latex weapons, or even if it's a boffer or something that you made yourself, you know, they really look good, and it might be something you want to showcase in your game room or living room or in your shed or wherever. But I know for me, I would like to have something hung on my wall, and here's how to make a hanger for it. First thing we're going to need, some pizza boxes. If you don't eat pizza or you don't have boxes like this, you need to find some cardboard boxes. But basically, we gotta get a couple boxes from somewhere. I chose pizza boxes because they're free after you eat the pizza, but you can get boxes from a lot of different places. Even if you end up having to pay for them, they're not very expensive. You're gonna need enough that you'll be able to glue a couple layers thick for the cardboard. I'll show you what I mean here in just a second. But get yourself, I'd say, at least two pizza boxes or equivalent of cardboard from somewhere else. But you're gonna wanna find a nice thick cardboard to work with. The next thing you're gonna need to do is determine what weapon you want to use. So for me, I'm going to use this sword here. And the reason why it's important to decide what weapon you're gonna use is because this would determine the size of how big the hanger needs to be. So if you're using a huge two-handed weapon or a smaller dagger or something, you're gonna need to adjust the size accordingly. And the last thing you're gonna need is a pattern for the wall hanger. So you're looking for a shield style pattern. Now you can, of course, freehand draw this, you can make it on your computer, but there's also sites online where you can download free patterns, which is basically what anyone can do because it's totally free. Just make sure you pick a royalty free and a free graphic option, and then you can just size those on your printer to whatever size you need for the weapon that you're making. So it's super easy, and it'll come out nice and clean and look great when it's done. Now, through the miracle of time, I've already created mine. So what I did here, as you can see, is I glued several pizza box tops together to give myself a nice thick base. Now, realistically, I would say I'd probably want to glue maybe another two or three on here because this cardboard wasn't very thick, but it's rigid enough, and that's what we're shooting for. And then I just used a PVA, you know, like a school glue, to glue it all together, put some books on it overnight so it stays nice and flat. And then, of course, this is my shield design that I drew. I freehanded mine, but you know, you can, like I said, print out something online if you're not able to do that, and then just trace it or just stick it on here as a last layer. Make sure the brown part is facing out on both sides though, because the finished product, we're not gonna want, you know, it to say, you know, Mike's Pizza on it or something. And then from there, it's basically just a matter of cutting this out, and then the sword will mount on it like this. And I would say it's important to do a dry fit first, because you want to make sure that it's going to look good on there, and that it fits and everything lines up. If it doesn't, you can adjust the parameters a little bit like I did on mine to make it look better for the size of the sword, you know, or you can reprint it, you know, a larger version, or whatever you need to do to make it work out. But pretty much the next step is just cutting this out, and you can use scissors or a razor. You could have cut it out before you glued it together. I chose to just do it this way because I'm going to just run it through my saw that I have, because it would be a lot faster than me trying to cut it. But you can definitely just use a box cutter or a razor to cut this out as well. And once that's cut out, I'll see you back here, and we'll move on to the next step, making this thing look good. And if things are going well for you, then so far you have this. So we have basically a shield cutout, and that's cardboard, thick cardboard. I've already taken the liberty to spray paint the backside of it black, and you can paint it whatever color you want. But you can see how thick that is. So essentially, we've made ourselves a piece of wood rather than using a piece of wood. Of course, if you have wood, you have a jigsaw or a bandsaw or a means to cut it, feel free to make this out of wood. That's gonna make it way better. If you have a routing table or a router and you can go around the edges, you could really make a legitimate piece for this. However, if you're in an apartment and all you have are some pizza boxes and a box cutter, then you can definitely make this. So that's what we're working with. Now on this, we're going to have our sword mounted to, of course, and then that will hang on our wall. Now at this point, really, you need to make some creative decisions. So there's a lot of stuff we can do here. So I painted one side of it flat black. I mean, you could just leave it like that if you want to. You could also paint it with a wood grain texture, which I think I'm going to try. And you could also just cover it in fabric. If you have a fabric that you can stretch tight enough to get around the corners, and you cut, you know, little edges and you just glue it to the back of this, and then you could always sandwich that with another piece of pizza box so that that's all concealed on the back. Or if you're never going to look at the back of it, you could just leave that all open and hang it on your wall. It won't really matter. Yeah, you know, but you could fabric wrap it. You could put popsicle sticks all over it. If you're doing a post-apocalyptic or some sort of, you know, other version other than medieval, you could put two license plates side by side, and you could have cut this out with a grinder or a Dremel or something. And really, just your imagination is the limit on this. I'm just looking to make, you know, a medieval looking sword hanger. Now, obviously, this also looks like a small game mount. So if you have, you know, some stuffed heads of some animals or a troll head or something, you could stick that on here and you can mount that on your wall as well. I mean, this obviously, you know, wouldn't fit anything too large. But if you have any sort of small diminutive creatures that you've slain in your game that you would like to represent, you could mock up a skull or a head of one of those, put it on here, and you could mount that on your wall as well. But I'm going to use it as a sword hanger. And, of course, alternatively, as a last resort, they do sell small game mounts that look just like this. And you could just buy one off of Amazon or something. But this is free, pretty much. So the next thing you need to do is, what do you want to do with the sides? Now, you could just leave these rough as they are. I have some, like, leather strip here that I could put around the outside of it. If you maybe have a nautical theme or something, you could do rope along the side, a thick twine, a thick rope. Or even if you're not nautical, I mean, you could do that if you like the look of it. So really, see what your character would do and the genre and what you think they would be hanging in their home. And that's what you base this off of. So we have the basic mount. Now, like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and try to paint this with a wood grain texture. If you're not sure how to paint a wood grain texture, it's basically start with a dark base coat. So dark brown, black, whatever color you want. It could be red, I mean, it could be bright blue. I don't know if you play in like a really sort of sci-fi, like Avatar type world. You could paint it whatever you want underneath, neon green so it glows in the dark, whatever you want. But you'll put a base coat down. And then you take and you use like a dry brushing technique to get the wood grain or simulated wood grain. If you remember the video where I made this crossbow, I sort of talk a little bit about how to make a wood grain texture, and I'll include a link for this on how to do that if you want. As far as painting it, I just have some cheap brown paint and a cheap kid's brush, and I'm just gonna try to do the simulated wood grain here. And like I said, it's really more or less just a dry brushing technique until you think it looks like what wood would look like. It's not going to probably, but you'll get it as close as you can. And the sword will cover up most of it anyways, so don't be afraid if you make a few mistakes. People aren't going to be looking at this, they're going to be looking at the weapon you have hung on it. So let me go ahead and paint this and I'll get right back to you. And with the painting done, here's what the project should look like so far. Now, this sort of wood grain look here that we have is created by just mixing some brown and some dark red, like a barn red and maybe a burnt umber. And you take a brush and just sort of mix it so that the colors aren't completely mixed together, and you just drag it down with a brush. Long strokes are the key. You want the stroke to continue the whole way through the entire shield here. So just start at the top, all the way down, all the way up, all the way down, all the way up. If you don't like this coloring, you can do just browns. You can do a light brown and a dark brown. You can do a dark brown and a darker brown. Like I said, whatever you want to do, sky's the limit, whatever fits your game and character. Now what we need to do, though, is decide how we're actually going to mount this. Now, we're going to need something right here in the center, and there's a couple ways to do this. You could just take bolts or screws or eyelet hooks and screw them in, because, you know, latex swords aren't that heavy. You could take pieces that are left over from the pizza box, from the cardboard. You can use a knife to cut slits through, and you could stick the cardboard in there and you could paint it to match, and then that way it would just hang on there. What I'm going to do, though, is I have this old belt that I had laying around. I also have some leather scraps. I might use the leather scraps, I'm not sure. I'm going to put two slits through this and I'm gonna put the belt through the back. That way I can adjust it, and that way I know it's not gonna fall down. If it's just mounted on two sort of mounting points, like this, then there's a possibility it could get knocked off or fall down. But if you put a strap around it, it's gonna stay secure to this, and that's what I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and take and cut two slits through it with a box cutter, or I may just take a drill and drill a few holes through that are appropriate sized, and then I can just loop the belt through and move on. And then, like I said, instead of having just, you know, two mounting points where this can slide off of or be lifted off of, we're gonna have, you know, a belt that wraps around it, and then that way it'll be nice and secure. So whatever your preference is and whatever your genre is, you can do, but that's gonna be the next step. I need to let this dry for a few minutes, though it's still a little bit wet. And now it's time to view the final product. So if you followed along, you should end up with something like this. So you have a simulated wood grain on there, and you have a piece of leather that you can slide your weapon through. Now on the back, you can either cut these flush and then glue them, or you can leave them adjustable like this and secure them with glue or some other way. You may even be able to compress this in between another piece of cardboard. That way later, you could adjust this if you want to put a different weapon in it. But if you're retiring, say like an old latex weapon that's broken or something that you're not going to use, then I think this is the best way. You can put the weapon in there, you can pull this tight through the back with some pliers, and it'll keep the weapon nice and secure on here. If you'd like, you could do a second one of these a little bit higher that would hold the hilt a little bit more firm, and then that way it would be really secure, or you can just do this one. It's entirely up to you and how much material that you have to make it. So for me right now, the total cost of this is zero. I had the glue, I had the paint, the cardboard's free, and I had this little piece of leather. So this project has cost me nothing but, you know, a little bit of time. Now, if you don't have the paint and all of that, I mean, realistically, you're still looking at probably, certainly under $5, maybe even under $3 to make this awesome sword hanger. And there's no excuse not to make one. Like I said, if you have the tools, the time, the talent, you can make it out of wood. You can get a lot more elaborate with it. Like I said, depending on your genre, you can make it out of license plates or some other medium. Whatever you want to do, but if you're looking for just a medieval sword wall hanger for a sword that you're retiring, or a sword that you'd rather display in your downtime than just leave in a box or in a closet or something, this is how to do it. Long-term storage, this may not be the best for the hilt of a latex sword, so just keep that in mind. However, the sword I'm putting on here is something that I'm retiring. It's not something that I'm using, so I'm gonna go ahead and stick it on here and just leave it sit probably for quite a while until need be to bring that sword out of retirement and use it. So the only thing left is to mount this back here on the wall, put the blade in its place, and call it a day. Let me go ahead and get that mounted real quick. I just wanted to show you how I mounted it to the wall. So basically just two screws into a stud, but make sure you put wide washers around the screws, because this is cardboard and it's very easy for those screws or nails to pull through. So you want to make sure that you have washers so that it doesn't come off. Now the sword will completely conceal those, and if it doesn't, you could always paint over them. I'm gonna go ahead and mount the sword on there, and we'll take, you know, a final look at the project. As you can see, I can now proudly display this LARP blade that I've retired, and it sits on the wall. I think that it looks great, and it was free to make this little display stand for it. And this is a lot better than it just sitting on a bookshelf or sitting in a back of a closet, you know, that I'm not using. This way it can be displayed. You know, if you have a whole bunch of them, you can make a line. You could almost have like an armory in your home, if you don't already, that is. But I think that anyone can do this project. Even if you left it bare cardboard, it would probably still look okay. If you don't have the tools or anything that's necessary, I feel like you could still use duct tape and a pizza box to do this. And at some point in time, you're going to be able to find a pizza box. And if you have duct tape that you use for boffers, you can make a duct tape version of this. In fact, if you're displaying a boffer sword, using duct tape may actually be a sort of, you know, funny way to display it if you made the actual display plaque out of just cardboard racked with duct tape. I think that that might be interesting. Now, some final thoughts on this project. I would probably felt line the back of it just because that's how I am. And I would bring it up around the sides a little bit. As is, I left it a little bit unfinished. If you wanted to give it a more sort of polished look and you don't have access to a router, what you could do is you could photocopy whatever the template is that you're going to use, or if you're freehanding it, draw a few that are just a little bit smaller in size, so maybe a couple percentage smaller overall. And what you could do is cut those out and then glue them on top, and that would give it sort of a larger backing and a smaller face when you mount it on there, and that would add another dimension of depth to it to make it look that much more cool. Now, if you have a coat of arms, or if you have a particular symbol that you have on your shield or something, you could paint this to go along with that and then mount the sword on it. So like I said, really depends on your character, depends on your genre, and depends on your style. But there are so many different ways to translate this project. I would really like to see how yours comes out. So if you do this project, please be sure to hit me up. Let me know. All my contact info is below in the description. You can get me on social media or just comment on here. I'd love to see what yours looks like if you decide to make this project. If you enjoyed this project, please subscribe to my channel. Many of you watch my channel week after week and you don't hit subscribe. I don't know what you're waiting for. Please click that button if you haven't already. Every month, I come out with a new video and I have lots of cool projects, and I try to keep them totally inclusive so that anyone with any skill level and any amount of money could perform these. And of course, we have sort of the beginner sort of level stuff, and then you can take it, you know, to your heart's content and run with the project. But I try to make sure that everything I do on my channel, anybody can be involved in. And this is something that I think even children would be able to make if you sat them down and cut out the pieces for them. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click like, certainly subscribe. If you feel so inclined as to help my channel grow and continue bringing this awesome content, there are also links in the description below that you can help to support this channel. But most of all, please just let people know that I'm here making these awesome videos and share them with everyone that you know, because I really want to make the LARP community a better place. I think a lot of these projects will really help people with their imaginations and just let them sort of run wild and create some awesome stuff to bring into their games and share with you as well. So, I thank you for watching, and of course, as always, adventure on.